The next question says, a plano-convex lens is made up of a material of refractive index mu is equal to 1.5. The radius of curvature of curved surface of the lens is 20 cm. If the plane surface is silvered, the focal length of the silvered lens will be. Now, here I can say the 1 by f equivalent for silvering of lens is minus 2 by f of lens, that is the focal length of the lens, plus 1 by focal length of the mirror. Now here, since the plane surface is silvered, I can say the mirror from which it may becomes is going to be a plane mirror. And for plane mirror, focal length is infinite. So I can say since plane surface is silvered, therefore focal length of the mirror part is going to be infinite. And the reciprocal becomes zero. So I can say the equivalent focal length becomes negative 2 times the focal length of the lens. Now, by the formula of the focal length of lens, 1 by f we know it's mu minus 1 bracket 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. R1 will be say positive. If I take the plano-convex lens like this, so this r1 is going to be positive and r2 is going to be infinite. So I can say the formula will turn to mu minus 1 into 1 by r. So mu minus 1 upon r. Now if we substitute the values, we get minus 2 into 1.5 minus 1 as 0.5 upon the radius of curvature as 20. So 2 into 0.5 is going to be 1. So this is going to be 1 by f equivalent as minus 1 by 20. That makes the focal length of equivalent focal length of that part as minus 20 centimeter. Since the option all the values are positive, they are actually asking only the magnitude of the focal length, but and not whether it's a concave or a convex type of mirror or a converging or a diverging type of mirror. So I would say the focal length, equivalent focal length of the combination is going to be 20 centimeter, and that is going to be the final answer.